Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we'll discuss a question which says that solve x square minus 3x minus 10 whole upon 1 minus x is greater than or equal to 2. Now let us start with the solution of the given question. Now where we have to solve this inequality, for this we will follow some steps to find its solution. Now in step 1, we write it in standard form. For this we will take 2 on the left hand side, so this inequality will be x square minus 3x minus 10 whole upon 1 minus x minus 2 is greater than or equal to 0. Now let us combine left hand side into single fraction. For this we will take LCM. So this implies, now in denominator we have 1 minus x, and in numerator we will have x square minus 3x minus 10 minus 2 into 1 minus x again, and this is greater than or equal to 0. So here we have combined the left hand side into single fraction. Now let us simplify it. So this implies x square minus 3x minus 10. Now minus 2 into 1 is minus 2. Minus 2 into minus x is plus 2x. Whole upon 1 minus x is greater than or equal to 0. This further implies, now combining the like terms in the numerator, we get x square. Now minus 3x plus 2x will be minus x. And minus 10 minus 2 is minus 12. Whole upon 1 minus x is greater than or equal to 0. Now this is the standard form . Now in step 2 we find real zeros of numerator and denominator. First of all, let us find zeros of numerator. For this we will equate this numerator to 0 and factorize. So we have x square minus x minus 12 is equal to 0. Now let us factorize it. So factorizing, we have x square minus 4x plus 3x minus 12 is equal to 0. Now here we have factorized by splitting the middle term. Now this further implies, now from these two terms, x is common. So it is x into x minus 4 the whole. And from these two terms, 3 is common. So it will be plus 3 into x minus 4 the whole is equal to 0. And this implies x minus 4 the whole into x plus 3 the whole is equal to 0. Now either x minus 4 is equal to 0 or x plus 3 is equal to 0. So this implies x is equal to 4 or x is equal to minus 3. Now here we have found the zeros of the numerator. Similarly, we will find zeros of denominator. Now we have denominator 1 minus x. Let us equate it to 0. So this implies x is equal to 1. Now here we have found 0 of the denominator. And we have already found zeros of numerator. Thus, the critical values are x is equal to minus 3, 1 and 4. Now, in step 3, plot all real zeros or critical values on number line. Now, this is the point minus 3, this is 1 and this is the point 4. Now, here you can see that we use blue dot, or we can say this dark circle for the point minus 3 and the point 4, but we are representing 1 by drawing this hollow circle, or we can say this open dot, because 1 is 0 of denominator, so it is restriction and will not be included in solution set. Now here you can see the values minus 3, 1 and 4 divide the number line into 4 intervals. This yellow shaded portion represents the open interval minus infinity to minus 3. Then this blue shaded portion represents the open interval minus 3 to 1. This pink shaded portion represents the open interval 1 to 4. And this green shaded portion represents the open interval 4 to infinity. So we have 4 intervals. Now, in step 4, choose test number in each interval and check the sign of inequality. Now let us take the first interval, that is the open interval minus infinity to minus 3, or we can write it as x is less than minus 3. Now let us take any value lying in this interval. So let x is equal to minus 4. Now let us put x is equal to minus 4 in the given inequality. So here we have minus 4 whole square minus of minus 4 minus 12 whole upon 1 minus of minus 4 is greater than or equal to 0, which implies now minus 4 whole square is 16, minus of minus 4 is plus 4 minus 12 whole upon 1 minus of minus 4 is 1 plus 4 is greater than or equal to 0. This further implies now 16 plus 4 is 20 and 20 minus 12 is 8 upon 1 plus 4 is 5 is greater than or equal to 0. This implies 1.6 is greater than or equal to 0, which is true. So this interval is the solution set of the given inequality. Now let us take the second interval, that is the open interval minus 3 to 1, or we can write it as minus 3 is less than x is less than 1. So let us take any value in this interval. So let x is equal to 0 that lies in this interval. Now putting x is equal to 0 in the given inequality, we get minus 12 is greater than or equal to 0, which is false. Thus, this interval is not the solution set of the given inequality. Now let us take the third interval, that is the open interval 1 to 4, or we can write it as 1 is less than x is less than 4. Now let us take any value in this interval. Now let x is equal to 3. Now putting x is equal to 3 in the given inequality, we get 3 is greater than or equal to 0, which is true. So this interval is the solution set of the given inequality. Now let us consider the fourth interval, that is the open interval 4 to infinity, or we can write it as x is greater than 4. Now let us take any value in this interval. So let x is equal to 5. Now, when we put x is equal to 5 in the given inequality, we get minus 2 is greater than or equal to 0, which is false. So, this interval is not the solution set of the given inequality. Now, in step 5, we construct sign chart. Now, this inequality is in standard form, that is, in the form P upon Q is greater than or equal to 0, where P and Q are non-zero polynomials, and this inequality is called rational inequality. Now, on this number line, we see that in the open interval minus infinity to minus 3, we have positive sign for the function P upon Q. Then, in the open interval minus 3 to 1, we have negative sign for the function P upon Q. Then, in the open interval 1 to 4, we have positive sign for the function P upon Q. And lastly, for the interval, that is the open interval 4 to infinity, we have negative sign for the function P upon Q. So we have open interval minus infinity to minus 3 and open interval 1 to 4 in solution set. Now, since x is equal to minus 3 and 4 are included in the solution set, because the given inequality is greater than equal to and they are zeros of numerator, that is minus 3 and 4 are zeros of numerator, thus solution set is semi-open interval minus infinity to minus 3 union semi-open interval 1 to 4. So this is the solution set of the given inequality where minus 3 and 4 are included. Now here we have plotted the solution set on the number line. Here we have colored that portion of the line, that is this number line, which forms solution of the given inequality. Now we can also write the solution set as, now this portion represents x is less than or equal to minus 3 and this portion represents 1 is less than x is less than or equal to 4. So the solution set is x is less than or equal to minus 3 or 1 is less than x is less than or equal to 4. So this is the solution of the given question. That's all for this session. Hope you all have enjoyed the session.